actually work the corner. He is the official corner man in this matchup.
I'm the corner man, and I'd like to invite you to join me on my great video journeys. Whether it's me doing my corner man shows, checking out some great sites, or checking out some beautiful restaurants, or using my alter ego, the wingman, where I'm checking out some beautiful buffalo wings and showcasing them. Or, thirdly, me doing my workouts, whether it's in the ring or just at the gym. Enjoy. Now, let's get to the video.
I tell you what, I'm actually the perfect wingman.
You are still dangerous. You can be my wingman anytime.
Bullshit. You can be mine.
It's a beautiful day. Check it out. I had to do a nice workout. Now I'm going to check out Nelly's Cafe. Nice historical spot here in Soho or Lower Manhattan. I love the corner. So I'm walking down Broadway. I haven't been here in a while on a nice beautiful day. A lot of folks. That's how it's going. A lot of folks just out here. Beautiful day. That's what you know. About to get to this spot. Almost there. So the corner man is about to reach Finelli's. There it is. Let's see how packed it is. Hopefully it's not. You know, they say it always gets packed. It's a small spot, it's a small little dive bar, but it's famous.
You videotape it.
Supposedly it's like the second oldest bar in NYC. Check it out. Finelli's. Look at this dive bar. Old building right there. Ladies.
Who you gonna call? The corner man.
So it is I, am numero uno, the UNO, unarguably number one corner man. That's corner man Juan Jeremy. And I'm at Finelli's Cafe. Right now I'm having me a nice chill draft Polonaise, Hefeweizen, with a nice little orange and lemon inside. I'm about to probably order some wings. I'm about to check out some of the nostalgia, a lot of boxing stuff, like a lot of cool boxing stuff.
Do you have a card here? I got one right here.
See you in a bit.
You know exactly who you must call. Any time of the day you can call. The corner man. The corner man. Yes, the corner man. The corner man. The corner man. Yes, the corner man.
Not only am I the corner man, and I am the wingman, and I am trying some wings right here. They look so good. They got some different sauces. I'm gonna dip them because you know I am carrying it. Every now and then I have it with the sauce, don't have the sauce. But this looks mighty good. I'm about to see how it goes. Yeah. So right now I'm enjoying these wings, nice and crunchy. Got three different sauces. Uno, dos.
Yeah.
And I'm dipping them and it's tasting good. No complaints. Corner man, I tell you what, man. Now, as a corner man, I see this Rocky Marciano, and all I think about is the barber scene of those old dudes and coming to America.
Marciano.
Oh, there they go. There they go. Every time I start talking about boxing, a white man got to pull Rocky Marciano out their ass. That's day one. Rocky Montana, Rocky Montana. Let me tell you something once and for all. Rocky Montana was good, but compared to Joe Louis, Rocky Montana ain't shit.
He beat Joe Louis' ass.
That's right, he did whoop Joe Louis' ass. Joe Louis was 75 years old when he fought.
I don't know how old he was, but he got an ass whooped.
Joe Louis had come out of retirement to fight Rocky Marciano. The man was 76 years old. Joe Louis always lied about his age. He lied about his age all the time. One time, Frank Sinatra comes out here and sat down in this chair. And I said, Frank, you hang out with Joe Louis. Just between me and you, how old is Joe Louis? You know what Frank told me? He said, hey, Joe Louis 137 years old. 137 years old.
Oh, man, you ain't never meet no Frank Sinatra.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck you!
Who's next?
Now, right here, we got some history. All the nicknames and all these views. Look at that. And then we got Rocky Marciano on the ground. Look at that. Nice amount.
Now, I just finished eating those wings, and let me tell you, they were crunchy, good. I just checked out the sitting room. They got an outside with the seating, you know, like all these restaurants now for the pandemic. And I walked in, what a great place to be. Being, I'm the corner man, and I'm inside Finelli's Cafe, the second oldest operating bar restaurant in New York City. This is history, the nostalgia in this here. Just looking at everything, I feel is great. And the wings was amazing. Beer's refreshing, nice, beautiful day here in NYC. So, just about to sign off, Corner Man, Wig Man. And just remember one thing. Everybody in life needs a corner man, and one day you will need one too. And if you didn't hear that, maybe my voice was low, audio. I always seem to have that problem. Everybody in life needs a corner man, and one day you will need one too. It deserves repeating. Ladies. When you're in the Soho area, for me it's called the Lower or Lower East Side, Manhattan. And you want to feel some nostalgia, you want some good bar vibes, you come down to Finelli's Cafe down in Prince Street. You know? Kuva. You know? Get a nice cold beer. Get some wings, got some burgers up here, got a nice full menu. You tell them the Corner Man sent you, and you there. Later.
Corner Man!
Head to my Leisha's gym right now just to check up to see what's popping up in there later.
First of all, this problem we got here, this is your responsibility. Now either you got the respect of your own people up there, or you got nothing. My people. I'll let them go with this thing on their own. Your brother, he'd be in so many fucking pieces right now, you couldn't put him back together again even if you had the directions. But I said no. I said Frankie Flannery is a man who knows when things have to be set right. And that you would never let your feelings get in the way of an important business decision. Now, what I told my people, Frankie, was wrong. Of course, this is a matter of some complexity. But if you don't solve this problem, I'm gonna have it solved for you. You understand that?
You don't have to worry about Frankie, man. And if he ain't okay, it's gonna be a dumpster full of dead guineas. Spaghetti's still on their forks.
Little D,
look, I can straighten the kid out. I mean, Jimmy Covello was a great guy. We all know this. The kid, you should have been there when I was reaming him out over this thing. The kid, if he could, he would have crawled in a hole and brought the hole in with him. If he could have find a hole to go into.
Don't embarrass yourself, Frankie. I know you don't want to insult me.
No.
But to be frivolous on a matter of such importance is an insult. This fucking bum is your brother. So I understand your need to pursue some hopeless course to try to save him. But everybody knows what's got to happen here. With every heartbeat, his miserable fucking douchebag life insults me. It's the thorn on my side, Frankie. Since we're together, it's a thorn in your side. Now look, Frankie. I gotta know. And I gotta know now. Are you gonna be able to pull this thorn out of our side? Brother Frank. So for the sake of family and blood, I'm going to give you this opportunity.
Looks like it's time to kick some guinea ass.
We didn't call yet, Jack. Jack, he said we don't go until we call if Pat called.
That ain't what he said.
Of course it's what he said. I was sitting right there.
Richard, what'd he say?
Hold.
Frankie!
About what?
What are you asking him for? He's fucking stupid. You don't want to fuck him up again.
But that ain't what he said.
It is what he said.
He said if he didn't call.
No, if we did call. If he did call.
If we said... He said if we didn't call.
If he did.
If he didn't.
Did.
Didn't.
Jack didn't.
Terry, listen.
Jack.
I was sitting in the fucking truck. I heard him. He said if he didn't call.
Jack, relax. No.
If we didn't fucking call.
Where was I?
You were there too.
Yeah, right.
When you were fucking deaf. I don't know. He said if we didn't call.
If he did. He said if he did call. Relax.
Richie.
I didn't hear him.
Oh, would you fucking stop it? He's fucking retarded. Nothing personal, Richard. You're stupid. That's not what he said. Jack, he said if he did call. If we call, we go. Otherwise, no.
Have a piece of cheesecake.
Man, this don't feel right.
Fuck! 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 Yeah, calm down. Jack. Listen. He said if he did call, it's gonna be... Relax. Would you relax?
Terry, I love you. Terry, I love you, but you're wrong.
I love you too, and I'm right.
You could be fucking dying. Now,
Jack,
let's go.
Jack,
let's go!
You want me to make that call for you, Mr. Flannery?
Tell your boy to stop moving around so much. He's interfering with my digestion.
Apple Denoli. Semana Zeit.
Let's fucking go!
Let's go. Come on.
I'm coming. I'm ready. All right. You want your clock?
No.
Big mistake. Big mistake.
Mr. Borelli, I really do gotta make a phone call. I mean, I must make it. My wife's not been feeling well. With your permission. Go. Make it go.
Thank you.
Even home. Either they forgot about us or this entire fucking neighborhood better get ready to duck. What's this? Frankie, I hope you're not looking to start a war here. In a war, we would crush you. You understand?